of some kind, and Barbara is standing in for George, if that's all right with you. Barbara, she said she would like to come and stand in for George, so I said, I figured that'd be fine with you. Yeah.
Ready, sir?
Yes.
We'll get the family first, and we'll just swearing in front of the Barbara.
This is my son. How are you, sir? This is Nancy Baker.
How are you? So nice to see you.
And you know her.
I do.
Hello.
This is my daughter Elizabeth behind Mary Barbara.
Oh, there.
My son Doug. How are you, sir?
Nice to see you again.
And right over here is Tegan Baker.
Hi.
This is Will Winston, Mr. President.
Hi. Can you get him on?
And Reba Baker.
Hi.
This is
Hey, Mr. President. Mike Baker. I see you.
Will Winston.
No.
Bo.
I mean, Bo Winston. And John Baker. And you know Susan, and you know.
Hello, Mr. President.
No, we'll wait for you.
You're going to wait?
Sometimes have so many children, you forget to get things out.
I thought. I kind of want this fireplace.
Yes, we're going to now recreate that in front of here, just with the attorney wife, Mrs. Bush, the Attorney General, and the President.
We're going to be broadening.
You're doing the oath.
Yes.
I think I should be in the middle of it. Shouldn't he be in the middle? No.
No, because you got this way. What we need to do is have you move just this way a little bit, because that dog is coming out of your head again from that face.
Let's not have that. Let's not have that.
You have to. Okay, now I'm going to bring the wires. We need to bring the wire photographers in. Okay, so.
I said I want to be here. I didn't mean I want to be featured.
Well, you're representing the Bush man?
Yeah.
We stand here for about 2 minutes.
It's growing. I, James A. Baker III, do solemnly swear.
I, James A. Baker III, do solemnly swear.
That I will support and defend the Constitution of the United States.
That I will support and defend the Constitution of the United States.
Against all enemies, foreign and domestic.
Against all enemies, foreign and domestic.
That I will bear true faith and allegiance to the same.
That I will bear true faith and allegiance to the same.
That I take this obligation freely.
That I take this obligation freely.
Without any mental reservation or purpose of evasion.
Without any mental reservation or purpose of evasion.
And that I will well and faithfully discharge.
And that I will well and faithfully discharge.
The duties of the office on which I am about to enter.
The duties of the office on which I am about to enter.
So help me God.
So help me God.
Congratulations.
Thank you. Okay.
Yeah. Get the family over here, please.
Stranger feels kind of out of place.
Mary Bonner.
You have to stand in front.
Or do you want to be in front? Where do we? Over here.
You
stay right
with
you. That's good. Okay. And Bob,
ready now?
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Jean, I told you that wasn't true. I told you that wasn't true.
Well,
thank you.
Now, could we have one with
There we go.
Now, let's get the president in here.
I feel so you're a director. A boss over here. Taxi driver.
There we go.
Thank you.
Thank you very much, Mr. President. Appreciate that.
Thank you. Thank you, sir.
Good to see you. There we go.
Almost. Camp David, here we go.
This is my assistant, Tom Dawson.
Hi, Mr. President. I met you in 1969 once when you talked with a group of Stanford students while you were governor at San Francisco Airport.
He's a Californian.
I was just saying to Kathy that who would have thought 16 years later?
I think I remember very well, at the airport.
Yeah, and you had a quiet series of meetings apparently with different students, and they collected about a dozen Stanford students, and I was one of them.
That was when we had to be careful, because the students would burn me at the stake if they could catch me.
Not anymore, not anymore.
He was one of the few right-wingers at Stanford.
Yes, sir. Thank you very much. Thank you.
Well, you'll see him from time to time. He's down there with me. Right? Okay.